Those shelves, the cupboard was empty and we filled up the cupboards. In the past 4 months, tremendous things have happened. But I think probably the biggest thing of all is the knowledge that we've gained of this disease, of this plague, of this virus, call it what you want, to help small businesses survive the shutdown. I approved over $670 billion for the Paycheck Protection Program. And Steve, that's been a tremendous success. And we're talking with Democrats about doing something further now. But the numbers, the way they're coming in, it's been really incredible. So we're able to spot it. But we're here to help businesses and to help people. To date, we've processed over 4.6 million small business loans, saving and supporting an estimated 50 million American jobs, Jovita. That's incredible. The small business owners that we have with us this afternoon all received the PPP loans, and now their businesses are on the road to recovery, and they're doing really well. We have a lot of businesses that are doing really well. We're talking about a V-shape. We're almost like an I shape. I is straight up and down, but I talked about V-shape, and a lot of people disagreed with me. Not everybody, but a lot of very smart Wall Streeters were disagreeing. Now they're pretty much coming on board, saying it looks like it could be a V. So a V is the thing we were shooting for, and it looks like that's what we've got. I want to thank our people and my representatives for their decisive actions. And last month, we added a record 2.5 million jobs. It's the highest in the history of our country in 1 month. That's the highest number of jobs. 2.5 million. The Dow rose above 26,000 points, and we saw the largest surge in retail sales ever recorded. Next year is shaping up to be one of the greatest years in the history of our country from an economic standpoint. I truly believe that. I think we're going to have a great third quarter. We're going to have a great fourth quarter, and next year is going to be a phenomenal year. I believe that NASDAQ actually set the record. During a pandemic, NASDAQ just set They broke their record, Larry. Is that a correct statement? So it was higher than even before. That's an amazing achievement. After I was elected president, our country added more than 7 million jobs, 12,000 factories, and trillions of dollars of wealth. We created nearly 9,000 opportunity zones, and African-American, Asian-American, and Hispanic-American unemployment and poverty reached all-time lows. We had the greatest employment numbers we've ever had, and then we had to turn it off. We saved millions of people by doing it. We did the right thing, and now we're turning it back on, and the numbers are going up much, much faster than anybody would have thought. And it's a great honor to see it. And these two governors, by the way, have done a fantastic job. Two very extraordinary men, Nebraska and Oklahoma. We built the strongest economy the world has ever seen before the virus, and together we're doing it again. So we did it before the virus, we had to turn it off, and now we're doing it again, and that's what's happening. So now I'd like to maybe we'll start off with Governor Ricketts, and then we'll get to my friend over here. I'll be seeing so much of you in the next couple of days, I'll take you second. Okay, thank you very much. Please.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. President, and to all of your team here. We really appreciate your effort, your leadership, and that of your teams to be able to help us through this pandemic and really give us the tools to be able to manage it. The PPP program you mentioned has been tremendously successful in Nebraska because of the great relationships our community bankers have.